Mr. Sameer, my name is Khurshid. I'm from Uncle K TV. And we'd like to know what, or not because I'm Pakistani, I'm doing this for all over the world.
Right.
So, because healthy competition always makes us improve.
That's right.
So, my intention is that are we ready enough to meet that competition which I have already seen here? So, what products do you import here? I'm an export to Dubai.
Well, thank you very much, first of all. We, at the moment, we are exporting potatoes, onions and mandarins to Dubai market and also to Gulf market, Russian sector and also to the Far East markets.
Okay.
As you said that, are we enough able to compete with others? Yes, just because still we are very cheaper.
Is that the only advantage you have?
Not only this advantage, because at this time of the world recession, day before yesterday I was in Berlin. There was an exhibition of fresh fruits and vegetables every year. It's a big event. Yearly I'm attending that event named Fruit Logistica.
No, that gladdened me by itself that you are going around the world.
Yes.
That shows interest. Okay.
Yes.
All right. Okay.
So I was there and everybody, our major competitor, let's take example of potatoes. Our major competitor in potatoes is Egypt at the moment. For example, if we take example for Russian market. Russia at the moment has imposed ban on EU and America products.
Okay,
on
that conflict which is
yes.
going on. Okay.
So Pakistan has got a big window to the Russia market. Pakistan meat, Pakistan vegetables has got a big window in Russian market. That's the way we can explore this market, because Russia is not a small market. It's a big market. That's an example.
And
of
a hungry market.
And a hungry market. Because potato is a cheapest food in vegetable, you can say. And Russia has a good demand for potatoes. Now, for the Gulf, our mandarins is way cheaper than Egyptian or Egyptian citrus or Turkish citrus or Spanish citrus. Because though we have a setback that our citrus has got seeds inside. They have developed seedless.
Who has developed seedless?
Every country, like Turkey, like Spain, like America, even China. They all develop seedless.
Okay, that's news to me. I didn't notice that.
Yes, without seeds they have.
Except for these small ones, which they are seedless, yes. But the big ones I didn't.
Big orange are also seedless.
So you're talking about mandarins.
Mandarins, yes.
Yeah, okay.
So, thing is this, with the help of the USAID, and they are providing technical assistance not only to the exporters but also to the growers. There are many growers here also. So I have been checked because I am going around the world to explore my products, to exhibit my products. The response I am getting from the European at the moment, they say your product is very cheap, no doubt. Presentation, your packing is very good.
Packing, you have come to that cardboard thing, not
yes.
those wooden boxes. And all
no, not wooden before. Boxes. We are exporting these into the corrugated boxes.
Yeah, that's
that,
what
that we import
it
from
looks
Dubai.
Looks like a gift pack. Yeah.
Yeah, that we import from Dubai.
These printed things?
Yes, these printed things.
That must be costly.
Not costly because...
How can you compete then?
No. If we import...
But 1 minute. I've been away for so long. We had a... some packing company in Pakistan. It's a European company, but they were doing good production of packing.
Packages. You're talking about packages.
Yeah. So what about them? They are not giving you this thing?
If we import for the re-export purpose, the government is giving incentive under the DTRE scheme.
Okay, so you're covered. You're not
yes,
losing on
not,
it.
Not
okay,
losing.
Okay, okay.
So, the thing I'm getting from packages or other company in Pakistan, I am about cheap than importing in from Dubai. And Dubai quality is very good at the moment. Because we have to be very careful in this. The cardboard material and all these things, it should be, it absorb moisture and all these things. Because it discharge moisture, no? Citrus. So we have to be very careful because the box itself is a very costly item. If we going to make things cheap like boxes, if we purchase like local, if it gets down
squashed
the
whole product, it will damage the
all the
box.
So So that's the thing.
And now, the when you are saying quality and the packaging, what about the transport?
Transport.
You are using by air or by?
No, by sea.
By sea.
Because if we take example of mandarins, we have got a good infrastructure at the orchard area itself, and we harvest the product, and then all the products go directly to the pack house. It gets washed,
and waxed, graded.
Waxed, washed, waxed, and then it come to the grading plant.
Okay. And then you put your label.
Then it will label, and then we put in the corrugated box, and immediately we transfer to the blast chillers, the cold stores we have. Before loading.
Okay, no, you're confusing me. I thought the lab, like mangoes and mandarin, if I knew the old supplier, they used to calculate the aging. You know, they would start raw, that by the time it reaches the country, it will become ripened. So you're not doing that,
Now things have
changed. That's news to me.
So
thank God, because the mango used to have that powder also, you know, to ripen
the,
it. That was dangerous.
That was very dangerous.
Yeah. So thank you very much. I just remember your name, Mr. Samir Ra. Yeah. So you have shown me the way, and I hope you succeed, and we'll be seeing more of your products.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye.